The goal of this tutorial is to show you how to set up the development environment and execute your first application on a SimpleLink CC3120 booster pack and MSP432 LaunchPad. We'll be doing this in two different integrated development environments, Code Composer Studio and IAR Embedded Workbench. Code Composer Studio is a free tool provided by TI. To use IAR, the user will need to purchase a license to use the full feature version. This tutorial assumes that the license has already been acquired. At the end of this tutorial, you should understand the basic networking capabilities which the CC3120 device provides, know where to download the required software for CC3120 development, be able to update the service pack using the Uniflash ImageCreator tool, and modify, rebuild, and execute the reference application from the debugger. It is important to understand the content of the reference application, which is used for this tutorial. The demo application is built as a shell command prompt and provides Wi-Fi capabilities like connect, disconnect, and scan, socket capabilities for UDP or TCP client and servers, network application capabilities like ping and MDNS, and transceiver mode, which gives the user a direct interface to the radio layer. Before we proceed, the following hardware should be acquired: a CC3120 booster pack, an MSP432 launchpad, a CC31XX emulator board, and an 802.11 B, G, or N wireless access point. An internet connection is not mandatory. We will also need one micro USB cable and a PC running at least Microsoft Windows 7 with wireless capabilities. For software, we need the latest CC3120 SDK plugin, the latest MSP432 SDK, CCS or IAR, Uniflash, the latest CC3120 service pack, a serial terminal emulator application such as TerraTerm, and a socket utility application such as Socket Test or iPerf. The software components mentioned in the previous slide can be obtained from these links. This tutorial assumes that these packages are installed at their default location. On the CC3120 booster pack and CC31XX emulation booster pack, make sure you have the jumpers configured as shown here. Mount the CC3120 booster pack on top of the CC31XX emulation booster pack. Make sure the alignment is correct by matching the white triangles on both of these boards. As a tip, the LDO/MCU jumper configuration is used for choosing the power source. We chose the MCU configuration as demonstrated in the last slide. If you want to supply power directly to the CC3120 booster pack, change the jumper to LDO and connect the USB power or J7 with another USB cable. To power the platforms, connect the J6 port of the CC31XX emulation board to the Windows PC using a micro USB cable. If the drivers were properly installed during the SDK installation, the PC should recognize and list the connected devices in the device manager as shown. Your boards are ready to be programmed. Launch the Uniflash application and select the CC3120/CC3220 device, then start ImageCreator. Select New Project, enter a project name, and choose CC3120 for the device type. Choose Develop for device mode and click Create Project. Click Connect on the right side of the screen to connect to the board. If the connection is successful, you'll see the confirmation message and the device information appears on the right side of the page. On the left side of the page, click Service Pack to bring up the Service Pack selection dialog. Click Browse and navigate to the Service Pack directory to select the binary. Now click the Program Image button on the right side of the page to enter the programming page. Click the Center Program Image button to start flashing the Service Pack binary file onto the CC3120 booster pack. This operation may take a while to complete. Once the process is finished, a confirmation dialog will appear. Back to the hardware, connect the MSP432 launchpad and the CC3120 booster pack together. Please make sure the jumper settings on the MSP432 launchpad are configured as shown in the left picture. Now align the white triangles as before with the CC31XX emulation board, and then connect the micro USB cable on the MSP432 launchpad. Download CCS version 7.1 or later. You can do this from TI's website. When running the installer, please use the default directory of CTI to follow along with this video and other trainings. During the installation process, when you are prompted to select the processor support, select SimpleLink CC3X wireless MCUs. You can select additional options as needed. Click Next, be sure that TI XDS debug probe support is already selected, and proceed with the installation. Please note that the installation may take a while to complete depending on the number of selections and your network speed. Once installation is finished, start CCS and you'll be prompted to choose your workspace folder where all your project files will reside. Launch a serial connection application. We are using TerraTerm throughout this tutorial, but any terminal emulation can be used. Go to File, New Connection, select Serial, and select the port that says XDS110 Class Application / User UART, and click OK. Go to Setup Serial Port, change the baud rate to 115.200, and keep the rest of the settings as shown. You can also save this configuration in TerraTerm. To do so, go to Setup, Save Setup, and overwrite the initialization file. This will make the configuration as the default. In CCS, import the Network Terminal Demo Application project to the workspace. Click on Project, go to Import CCS Projects, and browse the location of the SDK installation. Code Composer Studio will list all the CCS projects inside the specified directory and its subdirectories. Select the Network Terminal project for your MSP432 device and OS flavor. Click Finish and rebuild the project. When importing a demo project, an OS library project is also automatically imported. Building the demo project rebuilds the OS project as well. Open a terminal and set its parameters, then click on the green bug icon in the top menu to start debugging. Once the debug session starts, click the green arrow in the debug menu to start executing your code. Now go back to the terminal window. As the application is executing, you can see the available commands being printed and a shell prompt. Next, we're moving on to IAR. Download IAR Embedded Workbench version 7.80.1 or later for ARM. You can download this from IAR's official website. During installation, be sure to select TI-XDS as one of the debug probe drivers. You'll be prompted to install multiple additional software and drivers. Please follow the instructions to finish installation. Be sure you have included support for MSP432 devices. Once IAR is installed and licensed, we are ready to work with our first project. First, configure the environment variables. Browse to Tools, Configure Custom Argument Variables, go to the Global tab and click Import. Choose the custom argvars file located in your SDK installation /tools/IAR and restart IAR. Second, build the kernel. You will have to adjust a few locations. In your SDK, you will find the imports.make file. Edit this file and verify that the IAR ARM compiler path matches your PC setup. You can also check the other compilers for CCS and GCC. In order to compile the OS projects, you will have to run the makefile located under sdk/kernel by gmake. Next, import the Network Terminal Demo application to the workspace. Create a new empty project by going into Project, Create New Project, then choose the ARM toolchain. Choose an empty project and click OK. Browse to the location where you want to save this project and save as a file name. Choose Help, IAR Information Center for ARM, choose Integrated Solutions, and then scroll down and choose Texas Instruments Example Projects. Click on the Example Applications link. This link refers to the example root link in your argvars. Click on an example according to the type of device and OS flavor. All project files should be imported to the workspace. Save the workspace and rebuild the project. In order to create a binary image in addition to the .out file, a post-build step is also required. To do that, right-click the project and choose Options. On the Output Converter tab, mark the General Additional Output checkbox and change the output format to binary. Recompile and the binary should reside in debug.x. To start the debug session, select Project, Options from the menu, and select the debugger category. In the Setup tab, choose TI-XDS as the driver and click OK. Go to the TI-XDS category, choose TI-XDS 110 emulator as the emulator, and JTAG 4-pin as the interface. Finally, start debugging by clicking the green arrow on the top to start debugger. Now go back to the terminal window. You can see the available commands and a shell prompt. There are many networking capabilities in this demo. As one example, we provide a basic Wi-Fi and socket communication. You will need a CC3120 booster pack plus an MSP432 launchpad, a PC and an access point, and any socket utility installed on the PC. Scan for wireless networks and connect your CC3120 and PC to the same AP. See that the CC3120 will ping the PC. Set the PC as a TCP server and the CC3120 as a TCP client and send 500 packets. Follow the shell commands as shown, and sent 500 packets successfully message should appear on terminal and similar message on the PC.